Welcome to Using Census Data with Excel. I'm Adam Heckman. The vast majority of time, Excel as it is provides you what you need to access, combine, query, massage, transform, visualize, and otherwise play with your census data using the visualizations, the formulas, and the functions that are built in. There are, however, advanced tools for statistical analysis that you can use on census data. You just have to turn it on. You don't have to download anything. You need to turn it on. Let's do so. File, Options, and you'll see Add-ins. And at the bottom of the add-in, it says Manage Excel Add-ins. Click on Go and check Analysis ToolPak. And you'll note that once you check that off, you'll have a new button in your Data tab called Data Analysis. If I click on Data Analysis, I can see some of the things that I can do here. I can do regression testing, histograms, ANOVA correlation and covariance analyses, exponential smoothing, all of the tests, F-tests, Z-tests, T-tests, Foyer analysis, moving averages, rank and percentile summaries, sampling, and a more sophisticated random number generator than the standard function. Going through all these statistical functions and methods is well beyond the scope of this training, so I'll just give you a basic idea of how it can be used with census data with a few examples. So I have it enabled, and now what I want to do is data analysis usually starts with descriptive statistics. So I'll click on descriptive statistics here. I'll give it an input range and tell it that there's a label here. And I'll ask for summary statistics. Now I could ask for more things like confidence levels, et cetera, but I'm just gonna ask for summary statistics and I'm gonna tell it to put it in a new worksheet ply. I'll click on okay. And here it gives me my table. So statistics tool generates a report of univariate statistics for the data in my input range, giving me information about the central tendency, the variability of my data. And since I selected to place those statistics in their own sheet, this is a new sheet that gets created that shows you the simple statistics to form the starting point for a deeper analysis. Let's go back into our data for a second. Histogram chart is another thing that I can use the data analysis tools for. You may recall back in school, sometimes your letter grades were distributed with odd boundaries. It wasn't always 90 was an A and 80 was a B. Chances are good that your teacher used a histogram to determine what those letter grade boundaries would be and the number of scores that fell in that range. In this case, we're going to look at how median income is distributed. So I'm going to create a separate section here that gives me the bins. The bins are how I'm going to distribute my data. For example, I want one bin that represents income of 20,000 and under, another that represents 30,000 to 20,001, another one 40,000 down to 30,001, 50,000 down to 40,001, 60,000, 60,000, and 70,000. Those are my bins. So now I'll go into the data analysis tool. I'll choose histogram. And I'll say my input range is the median income levels. My bin range are what I just created. And in addition to giving me my frequencies, I want to chart the output. And I'll put it on a new worksheet ply. And I'll click on OK. On the left, you can see the bins and the frequency. And on the right, you can see the histogram.